All right, we've got challenge slide one here. Let's see what happens when I launch the marbles. First star, got it. Oh no, wait a minute, I see what's gonna happen. Oh no! Oh, they're getting stuck right over here. So, one thing I like to do with challenge slides is use wishful thinking. Stop and say, wow, I really wish that blank, and just fill in the blank. In this case, I really wish that this slide kind of stopped somewhere over here. So there's like a hole for the marbles to keep going. And then I'm thinking, well, as the marbles go down, if I can get that to happen, I really wish I could, then they come down this slide right here, get to this star, and there should be some kind of hole over here so that the marbles can then fall down, roll along, and hit this star. That would be really nice, wouldn't it? Well, I bet we can do it. If we click this slide right here, we see that it corresponds to this equation. And I look at my first slide, and they're giving us a hint here, aren't they? This slide goes along, but then all of a sudden it stops over here. And where is here? What is that spot? Well, I'm thinking, I go down, I look, that's when x is 5, right? No, that's where x is 6. That's a 6. Okay. Well, I notice if this is where x is 6, it doesn't work for if this function doesn't graph past x is equal to 6. Why? Look at this restraint right here. They put the curvy brackets in and they say x is less than 6. And that's a domain restriction. It's telling us to only graph this slide where x is less than 6. Don't graph beyond 6. So, what domain restriction can we put into this slide and this one here to make the holes where we need it? If you don't know, that's okay, right? Just type in something to get started. I'm going to type in x is less than 6. That didn't work, but I'll leave it there for a moment. And then, x is less than 6, just as a starting point. And it looks like, oh, look at that. Less than 6 seemed to work for this slide right here. And that makes sense. They're both kind of the same thing, just shifted apart. I can even see that in the equation. I've got a 4 here and a 10 there. They're 6 apart, 4 and 10. But the curvature, the 0.9x, is the same. Now, for this one, right? I can't have this happen because the marbles will just go off and they'll never reach this slide to begin with. So I can have this right here go less than 6, but I might kind of switch that around. What if I make it greater than 6? Okay, now I'm getting somewhere. We're going in the right direction. But the slide is not going to launch the marbles far enough. Here it goes. Oh. This star is not getting reached. So keep playing with this number right here until you get the slide to go as far as it needs to go. And think about why that's working, right? Don't just delete and try numbers go really fast, right? Don't just keep doing that. Change numbers strategically and then see if your prediction, if your conjecture about what should happen does happen. That's how you can really learn through this challenge. All right, hope this helped.